This is a community-supported legal education channel. Find out how you can support our mission at the links in the description below.
So you may have heard that your favorite ventriloquist comedian, Jeff Dunham, has had to file a lawsuit against OO Shirts, I guess it's OO Shirts, and T Chili, and an individual named Raymond Lay, or Lai, for all of these things, which we're not going to go over every one of them individually. We're going to go over the substance of the claims and then skip over the individual claims for liability. But copyright infringement, trademark, counterfeiting, false designation, unfair competition, contributory copyright, contributory trademark, vicarious copyright, vicarious trademark, California Civil Code, and common law misappropriation. Plaintiff is Jeff Dunham. He is trustee of the Jeff Dunham Trust. And he comes with this action. The current pandemic is one of the deadliest and most far-reaching tragedies in modern times, and individuals and entities who have attempted to profit off this disaster have been universally condemned and reviled. This case arises out of the outrageous, blatant, and malicious campaign of defendants Raymond Lay and his company OO Shirts to fraudulently profit off this tragedy through the indisputable infringement and misappropriation of the intellectual property and persona of Jeff Dunham, one of the most successful comedians of all time, by selling counterfeit t-shirts and other consumer products. This case is simple, and the facts are indisputable. Defendants are marketing, advertising, promoting, manufacturing, selling, and profiting off of consumer products, including face masks and t-shirts that clearly incorporate and exploit the world-famous ventriloquism characters that Jeff Dunham spent years to develop, which are protected by intellectual property law. In order to attract consumers to their websites, defendants have exploited the name, photograph, image, and likeness of Jeff Dunham himself, which has caused significant consumer confusion. While defendants' attempt to profit is particularly reprehensible, it is just the most recent example of their ongoing campaign of illegal conduct. Defendants have been engaging in this same conduct for years, which can be equated to a game of whack-a-mole. Dunham identifies infringing products on the websites and sends DMCA takedown notices. Defendants take down the infringing products. Defendants then put up for sale new infringing products and continue to misappropriate Dunham's name, photograph, image, and likeness. Enough is enough. Ripping off and exploiting the intellectual property of third parties and duping consumers into believing that they are purchasing legitimate merchandise when they're actually getting counterfeits is defendant's business model. Defendant OO Shirts, for example, has been sued on multiple occasions for the same conduct, including by HBO for selling knockoff Game of Thrones merchandise, thus further evidencing that defendants' illegal acts are knowing and willful. As an example of the most recent unlawful conduct, one of Jeff Dunham's earliest, most beloved, and well-known characters is Walter, a crotchety old man who has a brash and sarcastic view of the world. Walter's grumpy nature is immediately evident from the physical persona of his character seen below. In a shameful effort to profit off the pandemic, defendants have sold and will continue to sell overpriced face masks that display a counterfeited image of Walter wearing a blue hospital face mask, as seen in this screenshot from tchip.com, on which defendants have sold the infringing products. This is just the tip of the iceberg. Defendants have listed over 1,000 different infringing products for sale, including t-shirts, sweatshirts, blankets, mugs, and other consumer products that feature Jeff Dunham's beloved characters, including Ahmed, Bubba J, Peanut, and Jose Jalapeno on a Stick. And defendants have even set up a separate section of one of their websites for all of their Jeff Dunham-related products. Plaintiff seeks to recover substantial, compensatory, punitive, and statutory damages. So then, instead of belaboring the 34-page lawsuit, let's just take a look at what the substance of the claims is. So they manage OO Shirts. Jeff Dunham is an award-winning comedian who has produced these characters: Walter, Ahmed the Dead Terrorist, Bubba J, Peanut, and Jose Jalapeno on a Stick. Dunham has marketed, promoted, licensed, etc. He has registered the copyrights. I'm assuming he's registered the trademarks. He has. He has registered Ahmed. He has registered I Kill You. He has registered Jeff Dunham and Bubba J and Jose and Peanut and Walter. And they're all attached. And so they also have protectable trade dress. Defendants knowingly infringe upon plaintiff's intellectual property rights by creating, manufacturing, distributing large quantities of counterfeit clothing and printed material. Here are some examples. if you don't want a sarcastic answer, don't ask a stupid question. Or jingle bombs, I think I got screwed. Don't laugh at me because I'm dead or I kill you. Many more examples are attached as Exhibit C and Exhibit D. In addition, they are advertising, marketing, creating counterfeit products. Some of them are exact replicas of Dunham's products. A few examples are below. So here's his silence and drink like a Bubba J, silence and drink like an Ahmed, or a Jeff Dunham t-shirt with his caricatures as the four characters in The Wizard of Oz. Defendants have commercially exploited Dunham's name and likeness in connection with their advertising. Here is an image from an advertisement on Tea Chili, and so his likeness has been used as well. So they get into the claims for relief, copyright infringement, trademark infringement, all of which sounds totally normal. He's looking for $10 million in trademark damages just in one of the claims, $10 million under the copyright claims. Let's see what his final or total request for relief is. So he wants a preliminary injunction preventing them from doing all of that. Statutory damages of $150,000 per registered copyright and $2 million per registered trademark. Total ascertainable damages of not less than $10 million. Pre-judgment, post-judgment interest, reasonable attorney's fees, and all other relief. So in the land of things you don't ever want your opponent to have, here is their evidence. Here are various t-shirts on Tea Chili. Here's a good summary of all of them. And there's another 80 pages of this. There's Bubba J. There's Walter. Oh, and they're literally selling masks. They look hand-sewn. This one looks
N95 masks?
Really hand-sewn. Our masks offer great everyday protection, but please note these are not N95 masks. There you go. There's Ahmed saying F Corona. I mean, I'm not disputing that some of these are really funny, but they seem to be using Jeff Dunham's intellectual property. Let's see Exhibit C2, what this is. This is more. This is just more. This is still on teachili.com. I'm just going to page through. Okay, so this is like the individual listing of everything. Somebody took a lot of time to take all these screenshots. Let's look at this then. This is the other exhibit. So that's a lot of products. I don't know. You don't get to make this many products and have the lawsuit over for a simple amount of money. We are not fragile like a flower. We are fragile like a bomb. So yeah, I think that those companies are going to be basically sued out of existence with that many infringements. I don't see how a judge is going to be able to find like minimum damages or something. It wasn't just one, and they didn't know what they were doing, you know. It was many, it's hundreds here. So yeah, that's a pretty solid lawsuit, I think. And I think Ahmed's gonna have a great time suing on behalf of Jeff Dunham. I'd like to see Jeff Dunham appear represented by Ahmed. How about that? Can Ahmed don like a lawyer's suit and then represent Jeff Dunham in court? I would like to see that.
Dead lawyer.
Ahmed the dead lawyer.
Let's just enter into a merchandising deal with Jeff Dunham. Let's do it the right way.
Well, I did. I literally just tweeted at him and asked him for permission to make a t-shirt. So let me know what you think of that in the comments below. Everybody was asking me about Jeff Dunham and what lawsuit what he sued somebody for. So there you go. So thank you for joining me, everyone. That is our show. I am Leonard French, your favorite sheltering in place copyright attorney. This is a community-supported legal education channel. Thank you so very much to those of you who are supporting our channel financially on a monthly basis on patreon.com/LJFrench or sponsors.com/law. Thank you very much to our May $50 plus supporters, Joe Tyson, Wes Delge, Nicely Done Defense, Video Remonetized, John Steele, Gavin Barnard, Evie, Kyle Mudrock, Spirit Bear, Jan Negray, Michael Pierce, Daniel Perez, Blackleaf, Benjamin Hightoff, Steven, Otta, Cute Grills in Your Area, Longreach Jones, Zachary Cheney, Mullen PC, Ugly Grill, Shiloh T, Josh Baker, Gregory, and Rudolph Bescherer Jr. And thank you to the $5 plus supporters. Really appreciate all of you. I will see you in the videos that drop. Love you all. Have a great week. Bye.